Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be looking at how to save and install and use preset textures. So there are loads of preset textures already in Lightwave, so at the side here you have to make sure your surface editor is open, open presets, and then what you get is a load of different presets that you can just simply double click and use. So for instance, if I wanted to use this Iron Rust here, we can add it. But how do you install and create your own? So what I've done is created a bunch of presets. So what I'm going to do is show you where I've put them. So I've gone to this user, new presets, and here are the presets. Are a bunch of presets that I've actually created, as you can see here. So if I just double click one, and then what it'll do, this one I've called Amber, going for a bit of an amber kind of look. Just wait for it to clear, and it simply loads up like so. So, and I've also made custom thumbnails here for it. So how did I do these and how did I install them and go about doing it? So that's what we're going to look at. So the first thing you do when you create these is how do you install them? Now there's a couple of ways to install them. And if I just show you the folder, so I've got a contents folder. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to provide all these presets I've created for free, and both the contents directory for this and another scene I'm going to show you that I've used it on as this tutorial goes on, and I'll link them all to a Dropbox that people can have for free. But let's say I wanted to install them. So if I just go into my new Lightwave presets, so here's all the presets and what I've done. So we're looking at the amber, is I've created preview thumbnail here. This is a render. So to get this render, all I did was on my timeline, there's only one frame, is I've moved it to the end frame and I've made the camera go in. So what I've done is you can have a render out this like I've done, or on frame zero you can render the whole thing out like this one and have the whole object. Okay, so this scene is for I've used for creating and testing preset textures. So let's go back to the one I've been using. So what I do then is I render it out, and when it's rendered out I simply save it in the same folder as the preset. So some presets that I'm using have got images. If I give you images with these, you'll need to put them in the contents folder you're using, because otherwise Lightwave's not going to be able to find them. Because you're going to be working from that contents directory. Now another option is that you could put them in the preset folder as well. That's not something I do, because usually it'll ask you a question, even though it's in the actual preset folder, it's going to ask you where the images are because they're not in the images. So you need to copy these images to your image folder for that project. But it's not that hard, you just put all the images in a folder, call them preset images and leave them somewhere, so whenever you know you're going to use them in a new project you can just put them in the new contents folder. And again, here is the actual exported preset. So where do you put this and how do you do it? So let's say, going back to here, I do like this one, I've already got it, and I want to export it. So what you can do, there's a few things, but all I'm going to do is I'm going to right mouse click, I'm going to go down to where it says save, and I'm going to save the surface, and then I'm going to save it into here, which I already have done. So that's how you simply save it as well. You can go up here, do a similar thing. You can tell it to save to the preset shelf, which it saves it to. But what we're going to do is show you how to export them so you can keep them, send them people if you want, and how to install them. So once you've done that, so if we go back, there's two ways. The first way is you right mouse click, we're just going to copy it. And now the first thing you would think, well, they need to go in the preset folder. So go into your C drive, go into your program, find the new tech folder, newest version, support, Let's go into presets, surface presets, surface presets again, and then which folder do you want them in. So let's say I want to put them in the workspace. So these are just the default modeling ones. So let's paste it in there. Okay, so let's have a look at our presets and we've just gone and put it in there for us. Oh, wrong one. There we go. So there we have it. Look, it's there ready to use for us to use next time. However, this is fine, but I want to, and what it'll do, it'll use whatever's in the VPR currently. So if your VPR's fuzzy, it'll use a fuzzy image till it's settled, and it'll give the little preview. What I do is I don't actually put them in that folder. Reason being, if you right mouse click, because it's in the software itself's presets, not the user, some of this stuff's locked, so I can't delete it unless I delete it out of the folder and go and find it. I can't create subfolders, I can't rename it, and so on and so forth. So don't, what I'm saying is you can install it in there, but my suggestion is don't. My suggestion is to install it into your own user. So what I mean by that is, let's do it again, go into Amber, let's choose this, copy. This time we're going to go to the C drive, but instead of the program, we're going to go to user, choose your user, for me, Tony, new tech, Lightwave, newest version, presets, surface editor, and here's my new preset. So there's a workspace we can put stuff in, but I've created this folder and I've put in all those presets. So they're all there. So that's why in here, for this user, that's where they are. So that folder I've just shown you, that folder there that's in the user is all those there. The difference is when I right mouse click, all these are unlocked. So now what I can say is I want to replace this thumbnail with my own image. So I go into here off the desktop. Let's find that fungus. Here's the new updated one. I'm just going to use that, and now it updates it like so using this one. So you can reclaim it. I mean, you don't have to use this scene that I'm using, but you can see what they look like, and do you know what I mean? They look fairly good. So I'm just going to shift and click on here to make sure I'm on the texture, and again let's just choose blood fungus. Sorry, some of these names I've just made them up. I don't know what to call stuff. I've just, like I say, I was just experimenting and seeing what I can come up with. So some of these images, some of these textures do need images. So for instance, if we look in the surface, let's go around, which one do I know needs images? Copper tiles. So here's a preview, here's the surface, and here's the actual images I've used to construct it. So I've put all these images, so I selected them, and then I copied them, and then I went back into my image folder and pasted them here, look, like so. So when you, because I'm working from this contents directory, when I actually double click the copper plate, it knows those images are in that folder, so I don't have to go and not come up with a question saying can't find image. The ones that don't need images are completely self-built in the Lightwave node system. So all these are kind of built in the node system anyway, but that's how I've kind of created it and stuff. So same with the lava one, I think there's images for that. With carbon balls, this one you do not need anything. This is actually, it's just quite a simple one. It's just this dots preset kind of node that I've plugged in to the color, clear coat and bump, and then obviously if I double click it, you can change the size. So if I go up to say let's see what happens when I go 50 50 50. So now what we've got is like bigger and so on, and move it down to 20. And then you get this again. So some of them you don't need images, some of them you do. Once I'm happy with this, you can simply just click the little camera here and save it that way, or you can render it out. Mine will just render it out, but you can just go and, you know, click it, save it, and decide where you want to save it to and stuff and so on. But I just, like I said, I just rendered them out. So that's how you kind of install them all. And to be honest, all these are just me experimenting and seeing what they look like. However, they are created using this image. So what happens if you want to apply them to other images that have different, because some people create objects with no UV. So how do you go about that? So let's load up another scene that I've got. And I've got two scenes. So I've got this one I'm using now is the preset scene that you can create and test. And then I've got a test shape scene. So let's put this on. Like so. Let's just bring up under view. Let's bring up a new viewport window and put it onto camera. And then let's put on the VPR. So let me explain this scene. So this is what this scene is a HDR. Wrap round. I've got a little ground plane with a preset texture that I've created, and then I've got a ball that's got a UV, which UV surface. Then I've got a cube and a couple of smaller cubes that aren't UV surfaced, and I've done this on purpose. So, and then I've got like a depth of field to focus on the actual shapes or the middle shape or whatever, so you can see it. It gives it that depth and a nice kind of look. So let's say I wanted to add one of my preset textures to here. So let's see what happens. So what I'm going to do is hold shift and click on the texture so it goes to it. So I can do this with all of them. So all I'm doing is shift clicking. Holding shift and clicking it will jump to that texture for you. Then let's come on here and let's see this one, old cage. And press yes. So this is what happens. Nothing happens. It disappears. The reason it disappears is, let's go on the blocks and have a look. So originally, when I actually surfaced the scene I just showed you, the preset scene, it was using a UV. The blocks don't have a UV, so the UV channel is empty. It's all I've done is assigned a surface, so you need to let Lightwave know that. So all I'm going to do is go to cubic, because it was a cube. And I'm currently just going to leave it like that. And I'm going to go through each one of these images and do the same. So all I'm doing is switching UV to cube on each one. So it just means if you haven't used the UV, obviously you're going to have to change it because it's looking for that name of that UV. So that's it. I've double clicked it, and like I said, I've choose cubic because it's going around corners to cube. And then you can see this kind of old cage here looks quite cool, like so. So again, with the amber, let's shift click. Let's find another one, lava. Let's have a look at this one. And again, so this one's come through like so. So let's have a look why. So again, double click on the first lava. It's looking for a UV. I haven't got a UV. If it had a UV, you could just simply choose the UV, or sometimes it chooses it for you. So again, let's just jump between and let's put cubic on all these. So I'm double clicking and I'm just putting cubic on everything that needs to have cubic on. Like so. Okay, so here we are, and again, so this is 1 meter square, this box. However, the actual object in the other scene might have been 100 millimeters, I think it was. So obviously the sizes aren't matched up, so you can change these. So I can simply put, let's put 0.5 for each one. Okay. And other stuff you can do is you can come in and edit all this. So here, where this luma from this image clicks into the multiplier and is the luma, that's how much the glow of the red is. So let's put this up to say 30 so we can make it glow a bit more. And again, this with the actual Lava, it had a displacement map plugged in here. Now, to do a displacement map, you need polygons to do it. Let me just have a look. So this one hasn't got the polygons to push through. Look, can you see? It's just got the edges. So what you would do is you would come in, choose it, go to properties, go to displacement map, enable it, double click it. Sorry, wrong one. Surface displacement you would use. That was how. That's how you make the displacement work. You double click it and then you turn it up. But there's no polygon, so this one's just going to go kind of wrong. Like that. So let me just turn it up and show you what I mean. So it can't do it because there's no polygons there. So what it would do, it would push all these bumps out further, giving it that more depth if you had more polygons on it. So, but that's just giving you the kind of overview of how you would change it. So it's on some scenes, and also remember I'm using different lighting on here. So based on your lighting, the size of the object, and if you UV textured it, stuff might need changing. So one more, let's have a look. So I've got this Spider-Man kind of outfit bottom here. So if I click on it, double click, and again, let's go and let's make these smaller. So what are the other ones? So I want, let's put their X and the Y to say 20. So obviously they all need to be 20 because they all work together at the same size to give you the effect. There we go. And now we've got like a smaller version of it, which is quite nice. Let's clear this up a bit. Mouse refreshment. So, hopefully, you've understood what I'm talking about when it comes to installing these. If, for instance, so installing them as well, but let's say, for instance, let's go back to the ball. Let's put on blood fungus. I'm not sure why I called it that. It's more like a dodgy looking metal, but I like it. And let's have a look at the setup. So this has got a displacement map on, but it has got a few more polygons. So we could try and see if this will push through. So the more polygons, the smaller version of the polygons, the better. So surface displacement, double click it, and let's push it through. So what it's going to do, it's going to push all that nice red through look and make it more. So originally it was a ball, it's more like a molecule or something, but it looks quite cool. But obviously, if you're using surface displacement, you have to have something plugged into the surface displacement like this. And also you have to turn on surface displacement and then decide how far out you're going to go. And again, how far you're going to go is based on the object. So if this object's like half a meter by half a meter, if it was 20 meters, it's going to be a bigger distance. But again, it's as simple as that, really. I know I'm probably make it feel simple, but and again, so I've just added the amber back on. And the default for the amber is, it's only one, is a lot bigger than it originally was. So let's just try 50 mil in each, because I know it's a smaller object, so we're condensing it down. That's just one node, one little node, the crumple one, that I've come up with this little effect, and it's quite cool, as you can see. So hopefully, and again, hopefully you've understood this, but let's say, for instance, you wanted to come in here and, I don't know, let's say you wanted to add something else to it. I'm not sure. Let's take that off. Plug that in. Let's make it, let's say, .05. So let's add some kind of weird pattern to it and play around, and just let's say you just come up with something that you wanted to just make up for whatever reason. Okay, let's have a look at this. So there we go. So that looks a bit better. So straight away you're thinking, oh, I like that. It's quite cool. So go on to the actual box, right mouse click, save the surface. So if you create a new folder, call it amber, I don't know, block dots, like so. Amber dots, give it a name, like so, save it, and then render it out. Or like I say, I would be using that other scene, but you can render it out, or if you want, you can turn stuff off, and or like I say, wait for this to clear. But if you use this as the whole thing as a preset, you'll have everything in. But you can tell it to show just the surface preset. When I was on, well, I need to be on the actual surface preset actually for it. Not sure why it's jumping to the other one, which shouldn't do. Yeah, so it should. There we go. Yeah, so if I go on to, so at the top here, look, if you go to surface preset, it will just show you the surface preset like so, and then you can simply save it out at the top here and use that if you want to do that way. I mean, it's up to you, but hopefully you've enjoyed this tutorial. So please subscribe and share. I'm going to put a link in the description that's going to be to a Dropbox, which will give you all the actual presets for free. Obviously, when you've watched the tutorial, you'll understand what to do with them and where to install them. And I'll also give you this contents folder with this scene here and the original scene as well, so you can experiment and share. It's not hard to get into this and make lots of presets. I wish Lightwave themselves could, even I would pay for it, like an additional, I don't know, 200 presets pack for so much money that you could install. Or, but you could probably, I mean, I could have gone on and made another 20 of these and had like a preset pack of 50 myself and maybe sold them. But yeah, I'm all about sharing when it comes to Lightwave and supporting it as much as I can. So anyway, thanks for listening and look out for my next video. Bye.